Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can create tabs for custom objects that you created. So before starting, let me show you how you can search me on YouTube. You can type my name. My channel will be available there, so you can learn various programming languages on my channel. So I'm logging in Salesforce. So in my previous video, I created one object named as student. So first let me search about that. So you can see this object is created. Now I'm going to demonstrate you how you can create tab for this object. So for that purpose, you need to type tabs in setup. So the option tabs will be available there. You need to click on this option. So tabs are basically used for navigation purpose. So at top, you can see home, chatter, campaign, leads, account, contacts, opportunities, forecast. These all are tabs. And these tabs are related to specific objects. So let me show you for which entities you can create tabs. So you can create tabs for custom objects, you can create web tabs, you can create tabs for Visual Force pages, you can create tabs for Lightning pages. So right now, I hope you don't know about web, Visual Force and Lightning page, so leave it right now. We know how to create custom object because in my previous video, I demonstrated this. So now we can create tab for that object. So we need to click on new. So Salesforce automatically shows you the objects for which till now you have not created any tab. So you can see this option, select an existing custom object or create a new custom object now. So we need to select the existing one. So you can see it is showing student. So I selected that. Now you need to select the tab style. So through this magnifier or lookup window, you can select a particular style. So you need to select a particular option as a tab style. So I selected box. Then it is saying one optional option that choose a home page custom link to show as a splash page for the first time your user links. Sorry, your users click on this tab. So right now we don't have any splash page custom link. So I'm leaving it as it is. Now here you can enter a short description like we did in custom object. So I'm writing, this is a tab related to student object. Now I'm clicking on next. So while creating tab, we need to set some profile options also. So profile is a thing that is associated with a user. So whenever we create a user account in Salesforce, we need to assign a particular profile to that user. So we have various profiles in Salesforce. So some profiles are standard, like these are provided by Salesforce automatically. And we can also create our custom profiles. So profile basically we use for restricting the user access on particular things. Right, so let me tell you more about this. So we can read this thing. Choose the user profile for which the new custom tab will be available. Right, so this profile decide that your tab will be available to you or not. So if tab setting is available for a particular profile and you use that profile as your user uses that profile, then only you will be able to see that custom tab. Then it says you may also examine or alter the visibility of tabs from the detail and edit pages of each profile. So at the time of creation of tab, that is we are doing right now, we can control the profile setting. And it is saying that we can also change that setting by going to each profile page, right? So right now we are doing the first part only, like this thing, and the Second option you will get to know while you will be watching the video related to profile. So here two options are available: apply one tab visibility to all profiles and apply a different tab visibility to each profile, right? So if I select first option, so it provides three options: default on, default off, and tab hidden. So default on means your tab will be available at the top like this. These tabs are available: leads, account, contacts, opportunities. If I choose default off, then your tab will be available inside this plus. Like you can see it is showing all tabs. So if I click on this plus, so all tabs will be visible. So if you don't want to show your tab on that home page of this UI, then you can choose default off. And if you choose tab hidden, it means this tab will not be accessible for any of the profile, right? So then it means we don't have any use for this tab. So we don't do this for all profile. So we can select either default on and default off so that each profile user can access that particular tab related to any object. Now, if you want to hide that particular tab from a particular profile user, so you can do it this way, like choose this second option, apply a different tab visibility for each profile. So now you can set, like for analytics cloud integration user, you can choose default on. For this analytics cloud security user, you can choose default off. And for authenticated website, you can choose tab hidden. So the users who are having the profile authenticated website, they will not be able to see that tab because their profile's tab visibility is tab hidden. But analytics cloud integration user can see their tab on the top like this homepage, and analytics cloud security user will see their tab inside this plus, because the tab visibility for this profile is default off. So I hope you understood these two options. Like for different profiles, if you want to choose different tab visibility, you can choose second option. And if you want to choose same tab visibility for all profiles, then you can choose default on, or you can choose first option. And later on, you will, if you watch another video, you will get to know what profile is. So I will demonstrate you the profile in detail. So right now I'm moving to next. So this is the third option. It is also important: add to custom apps. So in your org, you may have various custom applications or standard applications. So it says choose the custom apps for which the new custom tab will be available. So I hope you understood this point, like for which app you want this tab should be available. Then further it says you may also examine or alter the visibility of tabs from the detail and edit page of each custom app. So you can do it later on also. So right now you can see it is showing name of all the custom apps. So some apps are provided by Salesforce and some we create as our own. So if I uncheck this include tab option, so this tab will not be available in any application. But if I choose it as it is, so this tab will be available on each application, right? So now I'm unchecking it and I'm choosing only this one, service, because right now we don't have our own app. In my next video, I will demonstrate you how you can create your custom application, and there we will be placing this tab in our custom application. So right now I'm choosing the service app that is provided by Salesforce. So this service app will be having this student tab so that we can access that. So I'm clicking on save. So you can see your custom tab is created. Its tab style is available here and its description, right? Now I'm moving to service. So I changed my application and here you can see this student tab is available here. And it is related to student object. and its name is automatically available in plural format. So I hope you remember we provided plural name for the object. So that is for this tab purpose. So if I click on the student, so it will show all the related records for the student object. So right now we don't have any record, so it is not showing anything. If I click on this view all and go, so you can see it is not showing any record. If we want to create new record, we can click on new student. So this is the default field that we created to fill the student name. If you remember, like we selected data type as text instead of number, so that we can provide the name of student as a unique entity. So this way I created the tab for the object student. I hope you understood how we can create tabs for any particular custom object and how we can place it in any application. Now, if I move to like any other application like Salesforce Chatter, you will see that tab is not available here. So this way we can set or we can select a particular application on which we want to show that tab related to any object. I hope you understood how we can create and place the tab. So again, this is the way you can access my YouTube channel. It is simple, you can search my name and channel will be available there. You can also watch videos related to various programming languages here. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you understood. And watch my another video in which I will be demonstrating how to create app fields and records. Thank you.